Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today, me and my family are going to visit Santee State Park in Santee, South Carolina. Hope that you enjoy the video. As always, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. We very much would appreciate it. And we hope you enjoy our adventure at Santee State Park. The trip from Columbia, South Carolina to Santee State Park is not bad. It took us about an hour and 15 minutes if you don't make any stops or have to make any detours or anything like that. But it's a pretty easy drive. This is my son, Ruben, playing in the leaves. He does not know it yet, but we are going camping. We haven't been camping all year, and I'm sure he will be surprised.
Got it? All right. Mama got help. Come on, let's go.
Now, I love spending time with my family, going camping, and things of that nature, but I do not like setting up camp. Sometimes putting up the tent can be very challenging, but thankfully, my wife purchased a quick and easy pop-up tent, but even with that, sometimes it's still not as easy as I would like it to be, but it's definitely better than not having a pop-up tent.
So we are at campsite 58. We just set up our tent, as you just saw us do that here on the video. And it's a pretty nice little area. Of course, you got your water, and you have your power that you can use. So I think we're gonna be pretty good. You have your hookup if you had a camper. Yep, I think we're gonna be pretty good tonight. So all right, now we just gotta finish setting up. Ruben, how excited are you?
Super excited.
Super excited.
So this is an air mattress. I highly recommend it if you're going to use a tent like we're using to camp out at any place that you're gonna go camping if you don't have a RV or a camper. But I highly recommend it. We love sleeping on these. Oh, actually, I'm gonna let my wife and my son sleep. I'm gonna sleep in my sleeping bag. But if you're interested in this, I will put a link in the description so you will be able to purchase it if you would like to have it next time you go camping. Now, one thing I want to advise you to do if you're gonna go camping at one of the campsites out here at Santee State Park is to bring a small rake. As you can see here, I'm using a piece of cardboard that I actually took from the box that I purchased for our air mattress to kind of rake the pine needles and everything away from the campsite so that it would be safe when we start our fire. Usually, sometimes the host camper that's out there will come out and blow your area, but since this was kind of a spare of the moment type of thing, we decided, you know, we're gonna just go and do this thing. I don't think they had time to come out and clear our area, so we should have brought our rake with us. So that's just something to keep in mind with you, just to remember to bring a rake with you. So I purchased the air mattress for my wife and my son. I decided I was just gonna sleep in the sleeping bag. That was a mistake. I should have got myself a air mattress as well because my back pain twice.
As you can see, this is the air mattress. It is blowing up. And it should be pretty comfortable for my wife and son if they decide to sleep on it tonight.
So as you can see, our tent is pretty spacious. It can hold about 6 people, has many windows and vents. It's a very comfortable experience.
Snack good? Yes, sir. Say it. Yes, sir. Santee State Park is probably the biggest state park that my family and I have ever been to. As you see me driving here, you can see that a lot of people are taking advantage of one of the camping areas that's at the state park. We were on the lakeshore view of the state park, and then there's also a crescent view. And as you drive here, you see that there's many campsites right next to the shore. So this is actually our first camping experience this year, and to be honest with you, I was not prepared. I had most of the stuff, but I did not have enough water, did not bring enough water. So I'm going to the little store area. I'm also gonna pick up some bait because I got my fishing license and my little boy wants some fish. So I'll pick up some bait there. And hopefully they have some water, some sodas or something that we can drink tonight. It was kind of cold this morning. It was 58, I think it's gonna be 50 tonight. For the low, so that's a pretty cold. I did not bring a heater. My wife was asking about that. So hopefully our sleeping bags that we have, that they will, hope they'll pass the test. If not, I will definitely hear it from my wife in the morning. So these maps that I'm showing you are of the campsites. We stayed at Lakeshore, and if you look towards the bottom, we stayed at campsite 58. There's two areas I mentioned before. You have the Lakeshore, and I think I said Crescent View before, but it's actually Cypress View. These are some really, really cool spots, and if you can get a spot next to the shore where you can view the lake, you can get some really, really good views. So I encourage you to check it out if you ever get a chance. So this is Lake Marion out here at Santee. You can't get views like this just anywhere. As you can see, the water is so calm and still. And I know my little boy's definitely gonna wanna try fishing. So it's gonna be his first time fishing. So I hope he enjoys it. He's not very patient, but we'll see how it goes. But we just love coming out and enjoying the great outdoors. It's our first time here at Santee, and we are very, very impressed. There is just something amazing about being able to sit around a campfire. I like to take some time out to impart wisdom into my son and to just encourage him and just spend time with my family. And this is a little bit of our experience at Santee at night.
God's before me.
Thou shalt not have any gods before me.
Thou shalt not bow down thyself to any graven image.
Thou not shall bow down to any other image.
That's right. You don't. So that's what I want you to understand, is that we are Christians, and because we are Christians, we serve God, and we don't bow down to any other god. We don't put anything before God. So this is our first time out here at Santee State Park. My wife just told how she enjoyed the park. And my son is having fun in the dark here, acting crazy. So far, we are enjoying the campsite. This is our, like I said earlier, this is our first camping experience of the year. We're looking forward in the morning to...
Is this our first time this year?
Yeah, it's our first time camping this year. Oh, wow. Really looking forward to going and walking the trails tomorrow and maybe get some fishing in.
We parked in the backyard.
What?
I mean, we camped in the backyard.
Yo, we did camp in our backyard, but that doesn't count. But yeah, we look forward to doing some camping, some hiking. To hiking on the trails tomorrow. I think there's two main trails out here. And we should hopefully get a good night's sleep. Hopefully it won't be too cold. And we'll see you tomorrow.
Bye.
Did you sleep good? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So, it's day two of our adventure here at the park. Just woke up. It looked okay. Should have got me an air mattress like I got my wife and son. I probably would have slept a little bit better. It wasn't too cold. We had a little heater inside there. Of course, you know, we have electrical outlets out here, but the sleeping bag was really warm. Probably I didn't need the heater. So I slept pretty good, but I will say if you can bring a little air mattress to go inside your tent, if your tent is big enough, you definitely want to do that. But I'm going to take my dog for a walk and get ready to start our day. So I actually sped up this part of the video because it took way too long for me to actually get this fire started. If you are an expert at starting a campfire, please send me some notes or something in the comments, and I would greatly, greatly appreciate it. So I do not know how to build a fire. I really don't know how to build a fire. That's one thing we gotta learn how to do. We'll see.
How can we build this fire?
We're trying, son. I don't know.
I'm gonna kick it.
Don't kick it. Campground host site right there. As you can see, there's a combination of RVs, tents like my family's. Some people just got some little pop-up tents. So I think this is probably one of the better campsites on the grounds here. It's 85, as you can see, is really close to the water. You have a really good view. Another good site, probably be this one coming up here, 86 or 87. These are probably the best ones on site. Right next to the water. I'm gonna walk down here, close to the lake. See things. Come on, come on. Nico is sniffing everything. Hasn't been on most of the videos, but gonna make him a star as well. Oh wow! Look at that. That's pretty cool. So this is why I bring my family out here, because you just can't appreciate God's beauty enough. I mean, it's just beautiful out here. Sun glistening over the water, the ripples in the water, the waves, and it's just a nice, cool, crisp breeze. It's just amazing out here. And it's been really good to be able to share this with my son and to be able to take time to instill my values, Christian values, with him, and just spend time with him. It's been amazing. And do it out here in the great outdoors, I think it's something that hopefully will remain with him and remember for the rest of his life. So far, 85, 86 have been the best camp spots that I can see around here to camp. But all of the camp spots are really, really good to come out here. And I think you just need to come out here and enjoy it and give it a try. The inner part of the camp area. It's a little bit too close for me, but still a good place for you to come if you want to. I think it would be pretty hard if you had a RV or something to be able to maybe back in. I don't have an RV, so I don't really know, but I think it would be a little bit challenging. But you can see, and this is the 119, so I think it's like 115 to 119 area that you can come out here as well. So this is an option. So it looks like we have some soup we're gonna eat for breakfast. My wife, she made some corn on the cob and these vegetarian bean patties. So that's what we're eating for breakfast this morning. So those little pots came in handy, huh? Mm-hmm.
I think you can eat the soup.
Why are you so excited right now, Reuben? You're going fishing? What is that you're holding? What type of fishing pole? It's called a cane pole. All right, show me how it opens up. Well, show me what you were so excited about. How do you make it long? Oh, is that your cane pole? All right, close it up, and I'll show you how to put the top on.
Go straight. That's okay. Just keep doing it. Lift it up so you don't hit it on the ground. Let's go. See when your orange and yellow bobber goes down. love floating. That's what it's supposed to do. It floats right there. Then when it gets a fish, it goes down, you pick it up, and you should be good to go.
And fish again.
Yep, and fish again. So why did you want to come fishing?
Because it's the best thing of all.
You think fishing is the best thing of all?
Mm-hmm. Because you get to fish, and when that hook goes down, I will catch a fish.
And then we can eat the fish. You gonna eat the fish, or you gonna put the fish back in the water?
I wanna look at it and put it back in the water. Because I wanna eat the beautiful ones.
We eat the beautiful fishes? Mm-hmm. Beautiful fish, just like. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. See?
We're spending all these days here.
You like it out here?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
Even when I get the fish.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. The bobber isn't going down. I love the ones hiding there.
Yeah, but you got to pay attention to your
Mama.
You gotta pay attention to your barber.
It's still not going down.
You gotta be patient, son.
I am patient.
All right.
There's a bottle out there.
These people throw stuff in the water they shouldn't do. Remember we talked about you have to take care of the environment and not throw stuff in the water? In the ocean, you can't throw stuff in the water, and I put some stuff on the ground. Supposed to take care of God's earth that God has given us. We need to take care of what God has given us.
But we are in.
We're not, but other people are, and that's why we see that bottle out there. All right. You see, when you're fishing, it's you gotta be patient. That's the main thing you gotta remember. You gotta be patient. Because a fish does not automatically just come on your line. So you gotta be patient. So we did not catch anything on that day, and my son's interest quickly faded, and he became more interested in playing with the worms. So Ruben, you just want to play with the worms? You don't like fishing?
Mm-mm.
What are you going to do with that worm? What are you going to do with the worm? That's what we use the fish with.
It.
Huh?
I'm going to keep it.
You're gonna get wet, nigga.
All right, scoot back. You're on. Lean
you
on
gonna
me.
Smile.
Lean on me. Lean on me.
But don't do it right, boy.
Lean on me. Let me see. Let me see. Lean on me.
Do it right. Over here. Big boat.
Oh, we can go down there.
Wait a minute. So as you can see, this is not an actual trail, but you can see that it is kind of a trail that people have been walking on And we were able to see a lot of cool things just walking along the shore at the state park. And so I encourage you to definitely check out some of the trails that they have out there. But it takes some time out to walk along the shore, and you'll see some pretty cool things, as we did as well.
You know what that is? I think it's either a clam or an oyster. I don't know. You see?
You want to hold it? Well, I'm looking at it. You want to give one to mommy? You know who might like this? I don't know. I think it's it looked like it's a little walking trail. You're on the recording.
Oh, sorry.
Get in front. Oh, look, see this little beach area here, Ruben? Look over, come on, Ruben. Come here. This was probably one of my favorite areas of the park and probably the most enjoyable time that I had with my family. As you can see, there are picnic tables out here. As we walked along, we also saw people had campfires and things of that nature out here. So it's a good place to come out and just to enjoy yourself and just to relax. And so you're not just limited just to the camping areas, but you can also come out to the beach area and enjoy yourself as well. So along the shoreline is not an actual trail, but it is an area that people do walk and frequent a lot out here at the state park. But this right here is an actual trail, Sinkhole Pond Nature Trail. And it's named that because there's a huge sinkhole right at the entrance of the trail. So all in all, this is probably one of our favorite state parks that we're definitely going to visit again. It has a lot of acreage out here to explore. We did not get a chance to explore all of it, but we really enjoyed what we were able to see. The views are amazing, and we definitely encourage you to come out and to check it out for yourself. Camping is definitely something that you want to take advantage of, along with the trails and everything that's out there. But if you can get a campsite next to the shore, you can have an opportunity to see some amazing views. So definitely want to check that out as well.
Thank you for watching our video. Please like, share, and subscribe. God bless.